we've been ministering over the last few weeks on relationships, and today I've entitled this, Built to Last. How many have noticed that many of the things that we buy today only last as long as the warranty? As soon as the warranty's up, they break. It seems like they design them just long enough so they don't have to kick anything out. The sad thing is, this type of thinking is happening in our families today. In America today, we have so many dysfunctional families. We have so many marriages that are failing. It's time that we went back to the Bible. It's time we went back and got the Word of God on it, so that our families will last, our marriages will last, and victory will come to the church. Now, I want you to hear this, because this is very prophetic, what I'm sharing with you this morning. Satan has a very strategic plan in weakening the power of the church. Now, what he's done is he's looked at the church on the outside, and he couldn't break through. So he decided that I'll go into the families. I'll destroy the families. I'll cause them to be dysfunctional. I'll break the unity in the family so that when they come into the church, they can't get into unity. And Jesus prayed that we would be in unity. Because the scripture says that if we grow in unity, we're going to develop into the fullness of Christ. The fullness of Christ is power. And so Satan's strategy is to wreck your family and to get it dysfunctional so that when you come into the body, you can't walk in unity because you can't even do it in your own family. And then if you got a church that can't walk in unity, how's it going to flow with other churches? And if we can't flow with other churches, how are we going to defeat the works of the devil? So you understand, when I preach this today, I'm not apologizing about anything. I'm going to step on some toes. I'm going to preach to you some stuff that will change your life and change the outcome of where you're going right now in your life if you're really ready. Are you ready? Come on. All you men and ladies, say, I'm ready.
I'm ready.
Okay, turn with me to Genesis, and we're going to look at verse 16, because we got to know where we need to work on. You know, what do I need to work on to get my family functional, where there's a oneness and a unity in my family? What do I need to work on? The verses we're looking at is actually spoken from God concerning the results of sin that came into the world. In fact, in verse 14, it says, because you have done this. Verse 17 says, because you have heeded the voice of your wife. In other words, this is why sin came into this world, because the woman was deceived and the man went ahead and responded to her, and death came in. Notice the result in verse 16. To the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply your sorrow and your conception. In pain you shall bring forth children. Your desire, circle that, put a star by it, shall be for your husband, and he shall rule over you. Now, first, desire. What does that mean? Look in chapter 4 and look down in verse 7. You see the same word used, and you'll find out that since sin came into the world, this is what this particular type of desire is. Verse 7. If you do well, will you not be accepted? If you do not do well, sin lies at the door, and its desire is for you. Same Hebrew word. Now notice that. Desire is for you, but you shall rule over it. In other words, when God said to the woman, you're going to desire your husband, that word desire means that you're going to want to control and compel him. Come on, ladies, say it with me. I have a tendency. Now, let's get this straight here. You're going to work with me. I have a tendency to control and compel my husband. All right, guys, when it says that the husband would rule over the wife, it's talking about in an unfair way. In other words, where a husband will, you know, want to be respected as the head and all that stuff, yet he neglects his responsibilities, puts more on his wife than he should, doesn't take care of her the way that he should, but yet I'm still the head, or he rules like a tyrant. And my wife, she reminds me all the time when I'm a chauvinist. And a man has a tendency to be a chauvinist, just like a woman has a tendency to want to control her husband. Now, I'm just telling you the truth, praise God. And so we need to address that issue if we want to drive the devil out of our homes and we want to get unity. We got to address that issue. Come on, we're going to address it here today. Now, you need to see this. The Bible says the husband is to be the head over the wife, and the wife is supposed to be submissive to her husband as unto the Lord. Can we give it an amen?
Amen.
All right, that means then that if your wife's in the driver's seat, you're in trouble. I said if your wife's in the driver's seat, you're in trouble. Write this down for a reference. 1 Timothy 2:14. It said that the woman was deceived, but the man wasn't. Why was the woman deceived in the Garden of Eden? Adam was standing right by her. Well, the devil was deceiving her. Instead of Adam saying, "Step aside, Eve. I'll handle this devil." He stepped back from his position of authority. She stepped in and started driving. And as soon as she started driving, she started getting deceived. Listen to me. If your wife has stepped into your role, you're going to have deception in your home, whether you like it or not. Don't shout me down because I'm preaching really good today. This is important that we see this. These are basics. You know, if a husband leads like Christ leads, his wife wants to follow. So one of the questions guys should ask themselves when the wife doesn't want to follow is, what is it, honey, that I'm not doing in your life that makes you